the way you talked about the product, Wendy and I actually had that same conversation when we were in testing, because we had samples of the product and we were using it ourselves, trying to see if it worked. And we were talking back and forth and we were like, is it working for you? And we were like, yeah, it's working. Oh my God, it's working.
Welcome to Come Back with Erica Cobb, a community of folks like yourselves who are getting ready and staying ready for their next chapter. Well, I know a lot of you, your chapter includes some really grand ideas of entrepreneurship, and you're going to need a little bit of inspiration. So today, I have the LA-based employed entrepreneurs, I will just reiterate that. They're mothers and besties, both juggling and balancing demanding corporate jobs and running their own intimate skincare brand as co-founders of Condition Her, the natural moisturizing cream that is scientifically formulated for your external intimate area. It effectively maintains pH balance, slays ingrowns, fights chafing issues, nourishes skin, and softens hair down there. Wendy Roseberry and Eugenia Marshall, welcome to Come Back with Erica Cobb.
The hair brand idea, like most of the ones that, you know, I come up with some that she's like, that ain't it, girl. That ain't it. You know? But this one, it stuck. It stuck in the initial idea, which happened in 2013. And short of the long, if you want me to share where it came from with you, is I was dating long distance. This brother had a preference, like a lot of folks have preferences. And his particular preference was had to do with intimate care. And he preferred a little more hair than the two-finger landing strip that I was keeping in my hoo-ha area, in my, you know, what we now know very well, and we're very intentional about calling the vulva, okay? Mm-hmm. The external part of our intimate area. And so, you know, he's very communicative and was able to express that in a way. And I was like, why? And he let me know that, you know, as an adult man in his late 30s, I think at the time, early 40s, that the presence of pubic hair was a sign of, you know, in his adolescence, it was a sign of maturity, grown woman. And it's just something that carried. And a lot of men feel that way. I think they might shift and change over the years, but that literally is what, and of course that conversation didn't spark the idea, but I did what most women do when things come up in their relationship. I took it to the girl chat.
Right.
I took it to the council. You know, which happened to be over drinks. We had a girls' night. My girlfriends were in Chicago too, and I said, "Listen, this brother asking me something crazy." I had been waxing since I was 18.
And sure. So
And you know, in telling the story, I said, "Okay, well, I guess you know, this new 70s bush lifestyle that I'm about to be leading. Like, how do I maintain this? How are we gonna, you know, keep this thing soft? You know, and it's cushy, I guess." And
right. So,
I said, well, have you, I said, I guess I'll do what I did in my teenage days. And they said, well, what did you do? And so I posed a question at that point. And the question was, have you ever used your hair conditioner or shampoo on your pubic hair? Mm-hmm. And some folks looked puzzled. And then a few kind of gave the eye open, like, no one's ever asked, but I'm about to confess. Yeah, I've done it. And you know, we laughed at the table about it. Why would you do it? When did you do it? For those of us that were doing, we were pretty much doing it for the same reason. And in my youth, in my late teens, it was a part of what I now know and what I now call is an intimate skincare regimen. Mm-hmm. Just like you have for your face, mm-hmm. and the way that you take care, you clean your face, you exfoliate your face, you moisturize your face, you do all sorts of things to keep your face, you know, healthy. Your vulva area needs and deserves and the same sort of attention. And so in my teen days, I was doing that on hair wash days by putting my Suave or Pantene in that area for the 2 minutes as well. Mm-hmm. Was it working? Probably not. Was it safe? Absolutely not. However, you know, in our research, that's what sparked the idea. I said, well, I guess I'm gonna have to make something if nothing exists. We came up with some pretty funny names about what we could make that night, but it did. I'm a marketer by trade, and so I woke up the next morning and right from bed, you know, picked up my phone and started Googling, you know, pubic hair conditioner, pubic hair softener, anything, and there was nothing. In 2013, there was nothing on the market. Not in the United States. There were certain products in Europe, And I called Gina and I said, I know we've never made anything. We've marketed and helped people build businesses that have consumer brands. I said, but I think I found a void in the market and people are asking for something. And women at the time were asking for something to soften their hair. We learned several years later, 3 years later to be exact, in 2016 when we met our chemist, was that that was very cosmetic of us to think, and that was not at all, that this was a health and wellness issue and that we had found a void in the market that was really necessary in terms of helping women maintain their pH balance, along with dealing with things like helping reduce the presence of ingrown hair, and then chafing, which, you know, irritation from the friction of your thighs or your body parts rubbing together. And all of those things combined let us know that this was actually something viable and that we should absolutely pursue. And that's what we did.
Well, I did a podcast a few weeks ago with the Period Doctor. So if people are going back and forth between your two podcasts, between Condition Her and the Period Doctor, we are getting all the information like to make sure that we are taking care of our intimate health and just our well-being in general. But I wanted to go back to the idea of you doing market research with your people, with your friends, your circle. And you mentioned that you are in marketing. So you call yourselves employed entrepreneurs. And that's something that apparently really identifies a lot of things in your life. So what do you think differentiates an entrepreneur in like a world where people are like, I'm just going to risk it all and I'm going to go for it and pursue my dream versus what you're doing as an employed entrepreneur?
One of the things that I think is actually really beautiful about being an employed entrepreneur is, especially in a relationship like Wendy and myself, is that I work in finance, and I'm a C-suite executive at a large accounting firm, a large business management firm. And Wendy is a marketing, you know, executive at a major company, Warner Brothers. So it's like what we learn in our day jobs actually help us really understand our business, and then vice versa. Things that we learn being entrepreneurs, we can actually bring back to our day jobs. And so in the beginning stages of, you know, like from actually taking something from literally a idea in Wendy's brain to actually having a physical product, because as you can see from our jobs, we're not doctors. We're just women who had a need, because when Wendy told me her need, I thought about it. I was like, yo girl, I have that same situation. And skincare and beauty products, like I'm dark skin, and as people say, black don't crack, I'm 46 years old.
Yes.
And so skincare is very, very important to me. And then when you start to think about it, your skin is all over your body. So it being women who just had a, you know, had a real need and developed something from nothing, if we did not have our day job, then we weren't as established as we are in our day jobs. We would have never gotten this far. Because Wendy being a marketing mind and being in publicity and understanding how all that works together is the reason why we're here on the podcast today. Because one of the first things that she had the foresight to recognize is that we needed a publicist. We're a small brand, we're trying to establish ourselves. We needed a publicist. Would we have thought about that if my partner was not an executive in marketing and publicity? No. On the other side, when we started, we had a financial plan. We had a business plan. We have really thought about these things. We've been in incubators, and she can throw that to me. She can say, Gina, put the financial, Gina, put the cash flows. I would not have that in my bank if it wasn't from my day job. So bringing those tools to the table is definitely great when you're starting your own business. And then as we're developing and as we're growing and building out and adding employees and things, we know exactly what we need. So it actually, I think, is beneficial, especially in the beginning.
I appreciate you both coming in virtually. Wendy Roseberry and Eugenia Marshall.
Yes.
From Condition Her. Tell us where we can get Condition Her and the Body Oddie earrings.
Oh, Gina, you want to tell them where you can get it, and then I want to make sure that we share a code with you. Go ahead, Gina.
You can find us at conditionher.com. As you know, we are a black-owned, black female-owned or woman-owned business.
Thank you.
and when you buy at conditionher.com, you are buying from us directly. So that money goes right into the pockets. And as Nikki says, buy from a black woman. When you support a black woman, you support a community. So I can honestly say that we are that. When you support us, you're supporting a community. Our entire team are, you know, it's full of amazing, badass women.
Yes.
And also, please follow us on Instagram, on Twitter, on Facebook at Condition Her. We're everywhere. And we are actively involved in those spaces. So we would love to connect with all of you.
And I just want to say, listen, so ladies, if you're still wondering and you didn't get it, if you want to just know, you know, whether you're leveling up or you're just establishing for the first time your intimate skincare regimen, when you visit conditionher.com, scroll on down. We have a 7-step regimen that you can follow. It tells you some information about some of the ingredients in the product. For those of you that are bare, absolutely use it as part of your daily regimen. For those of you that have, you know, grow the corona bush during the pandemic, because, you know, all of the waxing things were out and you just couldn't, and your husband or your partner for the first time even realized you had hair for the first time in your life, we're here for you too, girl. Go on over to conditionher.com and we're going to help out a little bit. You can use the code COMEBACK when you apply that, and you will get 20% off of your site-wide. As long as you use that code. And we just, again, appreciate your this time and the energy that you've put in and the interest that you've shown for our brand. It's opportunities like this that, to be honest, you asked about the silver lining earlier, and I don't think I touched that, but this is honestly the silver lining. Someone that, you know, saw us or got the pitch from our awesome publicist, who's a former colleague of mine, by the way, another perk of being an employed entrepreneur, because you meet people
right in
your space, our copy editor, those are all former colleagues of mine, but opportunities like this are such a big deal for us, for you guys to see us, to let us tell our story in the way that we want to tell it, and in an authentic way. And we really appreciate, this really is the silver lining for us, someone to have the product, have good things to say about the product, and offer this opportunity for us to share too. So thank you.
Well, this is my silver lining as well, because I get to learn, I get to be inspired, I get to form networks and sisterhoods through this medium. So I appreciate you both, Wendy and Eugenia. Condition Her, y'all, get the product now, whether it's the earrings or the unscented moisturizing cream. I'm just going to keep saying that for my super sensitive people out there. Conditionher.com. Use the code COMEBACK.
I hope you can get it from me.
Y'all, thank you so very much to my comeback community for the full podcast. Go and check them out on my online home, comeback.tv. I will have the code. I'll have the website. I'll have all of their social media handles, because I want you to stay connected. Thank you so much, ladies. I really appreciate it. We'll be right back.